everybody's everywhere. Hands in the air like we don't. A while ago, we had the one-on-one interviews with the TV stations and the radio station, I believe. So later on, if you have any question, just raise your hand and I will be the one to go to you. And then just an important reminder as well, Boy, with all the other family artists that she has with Cornerstone. As you mentioned, one of her influences is Casey Tandy. Aaronetta Colosio, June 2 at Waterfront Hotel. Welcome to your press conference for your show. Yes, we have all the media people here from all media networks here in, today in this room.
Mabuhay!
Yes, so please greet everyone and say hello.
Mabuhay!
Good afternoon.
Check, check.
Well, I'm Fabian.
I'm Alejandro.
I'm Daniel.
I'm Moira.
Hello, hello. I like the way that you said that, Moira. Like a Manzano brother. So, just to start things off, so how does it feel to have a show together? I think that's one of the questions that are lingering in the minds of everyone right now.
I think, yeah. No, it's very cool. We're very excited about this. We've been in the Philippines a lot of times. But we've never gotten to do a concert together with somebody that's local, honestly, and that has such a great voice and a great talent. So when the idea came up, we were very excited. We think it'll be different for fans, and it'll be fun.
Moira, would you like to add something? How does it feel to be performing with Boyce?
I'm very excited, and I'm very nervous at the moment to be sitting next to them for the first time. If you look at my most streamed artists on YouTube from way back when I first started, it would be AJ Rafael, JSD, and Boyce Avenue. And they have inspired me a lot as an artist, as a YouTuber.
What are some of your fondest memories of being in the Philippines? And also, what was your first reaction when you heard Moira sing? I mean, and as somebody who's been popular internationally, do you think Moira can make it also internationally? Hawaii or why not? Moira's on the spot there. Thank you.
You could be honest. I don't want to take offense.
I feel like Simon Cowell. No, but one of the
check, 1, 2. One of our favorite memories was the very, very first time that we performed here. I think it was February 2009. We got invited over here to do this mall tour, and we had never seen malls of that size. And we didn't know exactly what to expect. And I'll never forget, we were backstage, and we just heard the screaming and the passion. And when we walked out to take the stage, there was thousands of people, and we just had no clue what we were in for. And now, so many years later, we still come back, and the people are just as passionate. We get to play amazing venues like Aaronetta. So, you know, we love being here.
And as, you know, as far as Moira is concerned, I think we all 100% think she can make it internationally, because from what we've been hearing and what we've seen in her videos, is that she's the queen of emotion, you know, putting that honesty and that genuine emotion out. And I think with us, that's kind of been the biggest reason that we've been able to do well internationally, is I think people all over the world want to see that genuine emotion. So we're excited to see what happens with her career. I think it's gonna be incredible.
Moira, would you like to react to that?
Just sliding down into action.
All right, any more questions? Any more questions? Now speaking of, how different will your show be?
Well, you know, Alejandro was mentioning the first shows that we did here that left kind of an indelible impact on us. It's been unforgettable. And so
for years we've been playing as a full band. If you listen to any of our original music, it's kind of a pop rock, it's, you know, Coldplay, Blue Blue Dolls inspired sound. And so for this year, and for this tour in particular, we decided we wanted to go back to doing a more intimate acoustic set, more kind of like what you would see in our videos, for example. And we wanted to try to bring what you get from our videos and actually bring it to the stage. And it's a little daunting to play such a big venue with you know, really just three of us and to have it be really that stripped down. But I think that what it'll do is it'll put an emphasis on his voice and the lyrics and the beauty of the music, and we hope that the fans will appreciate it.
Hi, good afternoon. So, welcome to the meetings. Boyce, I'm here. And Moira, I'm a fan of yours. I love your song. Your songs, actually. So, since this is a back-to-back concert, so how many songs are we expecting from Boyce and how many songs from Moira? And are you singing together in the concert? Or how will it go? Moira first, then Boyce for alternate. How will it go?
He wants to know all the details.
Yeah. Tell him the concert.
I'm going to the show. But no, I think Moira will start and she'll do what she does. I'm not sure what her set will be exactly. She can speak as to that. And then when it comes to us, we're going to do a pretty full set like we normally do. I think it's, I would say like 20 songs. So
I think that's the longest set we've ever done.
Yeah, we tried to add some songs, it'll be the longest set that we've probably ever played on stage. And we are hoping to, well, supposed to be surprised, which you're ruining it, basically. But we are hoping to do something together.
I'm going to
be
my
part of this voice.
Are you
going to
adopt
her?
I don't need voice and hearing.
There's a reporter under there.
The timing, she's been very busy, we've been very busy, and obviously we've got, you know, vast oceans separating us. But if we can find a way to put it together, you know, we would like to do it. There's something about her voice and just the passion that she brings to her music that we think would go really well with what we do. So if we can get it going someday, it is something we would be excited to do.
It might be a good excuse for her to come to a tour in the U.S.
Right.
Yeah. Go international.
And if ever that would happen, I mean, we're just throwing it into the universe, right? Who knows? And if ever it does happen, like you saw your video with Sarah Hyland, I mean, what would be the feel of that music, that collaboration? Would it be a cover or would it be an original?
I think it would be a cover. I think what we've been excited to try to do, if we can pull it off, would be to do like what we did with the Sarah Hyland video, to just do one really good cover song, something that's a duet that, you know, ideally has a lot of emotion and passion to it. But sometimes, you know, what, honestly, you have to find the right song. Right now, in the state of pop music, a lot of the music doesn't have the depth lyrically that we kind of enjoy personally to redo or make, you know, put our stamp on. And so we're finding that we're having to be more and more patient with song selection and what songs we feel like we actually really want to cover. So that's an obstacle as well.
All right, how about Moira? What would be the first song that comes to mind if you were to do a collaboration with Boyce Avenue?
I feel like for me that's a very hard question because I want to redo a lot of covers that they've already done.
No, I mean redo it in terms of,
can I add my voice in there? Can I be part of what's happening? But for sure, even if we could possibly do an original, I mean originals just like pop out of nowhere, so you know, you never know what day you're gonna get to collaborate and if, you know, there's a lot of creative juice with you on that day. So yeah, I think whatever is gonna come out will be great because it's them and they're always excellent in a lot of the things and everything they do. Every video is a sure hit, and so
Yeah, I think just in general, this is kind of like the very beginning of like a long relationship, and we're glad we're just getting to meet her and hang out with her and stuff, and who knows what will happen in the future. There was a song on our last regional album that I wrote that I felt could have been like a good duet, and then it kind of ended up just staying, you know, a purely voice song, but now knowing somebody like her, it's, you know, who knows what will pop up in the future. It might take a little bit of time, but it's always great to meet talented musicians like this and keep in touch.
Thank you very much. You know, to be able to be with one of my influences in the biggest stage I've ever performed in, that's something you don't take lightly. It's something that is very, you need time to like have it sink in. And I've been trying to practice my guitar again. I kind of gave it up for a little bit because I wanted to focus on performing, because I'm very shy and I tend to close my eyes and I tend to stay there and forget that I'm an audience because I get too shy. So I wanted to take my comfort zone out for a little bit just to focus on songwriting and performing. So this time around, because they had inspired me to further play the guitar when I was younger, I kind of want to bring it back on stage with me tomorrow. And yeah, I've just been preparing mostly mentally because I'm very nervous. I've only released what's my line in Just Love? Isa lang po kasi linya ko dun sa Just Love. So yun lang po yung nakanta ko pa lang sa Arenata. So to be able to sing 10 songs, I have to mentally prepare myself so I don't shut down and get too scared. But I think I've prepared a little bit enough to be able to share the stage with them tomorrow.
Thank you, Moira. And for that,
when I start just playing it on a guitar or on a piano, and I think that's kind of more from the musical side of it. I feel like we feel like in running our channel that we do have a responsibility to be honest, but as well to give the fans a variety. So I feel like that's kind of part of our approach as well, is that we like to mix it up. We don't like to do too many old songs or too many new songs. We like to try to ultimately run an entertaining channel that kind of keeps people on their toes. So that kind of goes into how we pick songs as well. We love to pick timeless classics, but we also love to try and find what songs that are new and fresh and how we can kind of give it more of our own sound. Yeah, I think the tricky part with music is it's all very subjective and very emotional, you know what I mean? There's not really a mathematical formula where like a song comes and if it's a certain progression, oh, then I guarantee you're gonna like it. Sometimes songs that you would just never expect will resonate for different reasons. That's what's cool about music, is a lot of times it's just a feeling. You just listen to a song, you're like, man, I really connect, I love that song, I don't know why, but I love it. So there's not really like a formula, you know.
How do you guys feel when the fans say that they like your versions more than the original? And, have you gotten shout outs from the artists whose songs you covered and praised for your covers?
So in the earliest days of YouTube, we started noticing a comment on a lot of our videos that would say like better than the original, and we were really hurt by it originally because we actually thought they were saying that the covers were way better than our own songs, and what people really meant was that they thought it was better than the original artists. So we started noticing that was a trend and a huge compliment, actually, and so we started to feel like a huge sense of responsibility, you know, like we're actually doing something that puts our own personality into the song, and that's what we figure is what people are appreciating or liking. Basically saying, like, this version, you know, feels like you, or it feels different, it feels like it has a whole different personality, a whole different flavor, a whole different character. And so we decided early on that we can very much stick with being true to that. And Moira was actually kind of talking about that. I was very impressed that she mentioned consistency and being true to yourself, because when we're asked what we would recommend to other artists who are starting a channel or trying to develop a fan base, those are probably at the top of the list of the things that we mentioned. So for us, we do always strive to make the song sound like us, and it's an honor when people think that that maybe is as good or different from the original. So that is a huge compliment when people say that. It means what we've done worked, you know.
We have our next question over here.
That's a good question. I feel like in some ways it's changed for the better, and then in other ways it's changed for, it's tough to say, the worse, because I think it all depends on what generation you kind of grew up in. I feel like we grew up in a more CD, album type generation over singles, but we kind of as well got to see the evolution. Like, if somebody had told me when I was a kid that something like Spotify would exist, as much as I loved albums at the time, I would have absolutely flipped out in the best ways over the idea of having a device that had millions of songs. But at the same time, I still look fondly on the memories of going to a store and just, in a way, there was just so much of a focused energy towards one artist and one album, and just giving the whole rest of your day to that one album, that I feel like is maybe a little bit lost. But at the same time, I feel like social media has allowed for a more personal connection with your fans. They get to kind of go on the journey with you. A lot of stuff like this, you see how many smartphones, a lot of people will get to see us talking and sharing our feelings that didn't exist before social media. So it's kind of this balance. But I think that's part of our, thankfully, of why we've been successful in it, is that even within just the 10 years of us being present online, we've kind of shifted from CDs to iTunes to Spotify. And then we'll shift to whatever the next evolution is of the industry.
Yeah, for me, I think the greatest thing that YouTube and other social media platforms has brought along is just being able to connect with people who are far away, right? I mean, the first country we ever played that was not the United States was the Philippines. And it couldn't be, it's literally one of the farthest countries away from us, you know, possible. And a band wouldn't have been able to do that 20 years ago. YouTube allowed us to be able to go travel the world like that. So, and I think as we get into the future and new social media sites keep popping up, it's going to only get even more connected in crazy ways that we probably can't even think of. So we're so grateful for YouTube and social media.
All right, we have our next question over here.
There was about six young 12-year-old kids playing there. We played together. They challenged me to a game.
Didn't they?
You were the NBA. So you might have been the NBA. No, there was this one young girl who was incredibly good. And, you know, so there's a lot of things we love to do recreationally, like boxing, which you guys have a very strong boxing culture here, and basketball. We'd love to go to a good restaurant at some point, maybe some shopping. So there's lots that we love to do here. Sometimes we don't have enough time to do it all because it's show after show, and we have to fly from here to Cebu, and you have to get up early to get on that flight. But yeah, there's so much that we love to do here in the Philippines, so we're going to try.
All right, your next question is over here.
For us, there's mostly pros. I mean, the truth is we don't really fight that much. When we do fight, we really go for it.
Never with fists, only with words.
No, well, verbally, yeah.
It's aggressive.
Only a couple times a year, but, you know, I'd say that we can go entire tours, entire months, and not have a dispute, just get along. We grew up. See, I think what happened is, and I don't know if people can relate to this or not, but we grew up in a Hispanic culture. It was very close-knit. Family was the most important thing. We never did anything separately. All of our vacations, we were always together. We never got sent off to separate camps or different things. It was just always the brothers together. In fact, for a while, we grew up all in the same room, even all in the same bed. And so we learned to respect each other's space, respect each other's different talents. So we basically became best friends. That's even why I think we even did music, because Alejandro just started singing and got really passionate about it. And Fabian and I were like, well, you know, we're a team, we're going to do this too. And so I think for us it's mostly pros.
Do you have any brothers or sisters? No?
No, I have five. I have the eldest.
Five?
I have five.
Oh, wow.
But they're
different families.
Oh, so you kicked them out of the band?
They all sing though. I'm the only child, so all my friends are half siblings, but they're all very close to me. Yeah, we fight. Physically. But we have time for two more questions.
I think, you know, what's interesting, Amanda was talking a little bit about this earlier when we were talking about YouTube and social media and, you know, how everything keeps changing. You know, when we first started, we had these goals of things we wanted to do and things we wanted to achieve. And a lot of those we did achieve, but then some of them we had to kind of cut loose and be like, and realize that maybe we weren't going to achieve them just because the industry has changed so much. So now I think for us, the dream and the goal is to just continue to be flexible and to work hard, and as things change, to go with the flow. I think sometimes, unfortunately, musicians don't want to compromise or change, and then that's kind of maybe when their careers start to suffer. But you can't get too, I think, bogged down with what you think you want to do. You have to just kind of go with the flow. But I hope we keep touring and making music together as brothers for a long, long time. But what do you want?
Maybe someday do like a hologram concert.
He's really into future and like a lot of the weird stuff that's going to happen in the future. So you might have to talk with him separately. But yeah.
We're not actually up here right now. This is holographic.
But he's kind of kidding, but it also is a little crazy, right? Like when virtual reality and all this stuff, even the concept of live streaming is interesting, right? That you can almost be doing a concert from your bedroom that people all over the world can be seeing live. It's almost a little scary, to be honest, but we do have a lot that we want to achieve, and we want to keep writing music, we want to keep touring, we want to keep meeting new musicians like Moira, collaborating, learning new things. So yeah, there's a lot we want to do. We're old, but we're not dead, you know, we're not that old.
Thank you for that. For Moira, I have a question. Since you mentioned going global, is there a particular country na target mo to release your music?
USA.
Woo!
USA. USA.
Any examples on your plans?
Well, when I went to the States in 2016, my cousin Niman, he's a singer-songwriter in LA also, and he had created for himself a team of producers and, you know, arrangers that just wanted to collaborate, and they managed to do that. And when I went there, I was there for just 2 months, and I was leaving in a week, and we had managed to write, produce, record 10 songs already, and 4 of those are coming out very soon under Tarshir Records. And we plan on going global in the US just because in the past years that I've been going back and forth to see my family, I have done shows, like small intimate shows with my cousin, and I feel like we've already created an atmosphere there where we could be free to just, you know, explore different types of genres for me. So I feel like we could grow more there, and plus Boyce Avenue is in America, so I have to follow them around.
Have you noticed by any chance, is Brazil a good market for you, like through YouTube or anything like that?
I would love to. I want to.
Yeah.
I learned how to dance first.
Yeah. For some reason, besides the Philippines, Brazil has been a great market for us. So it seems like they kind of absorb and appreciate music the way you guys do. So that's why I just didn't know if, you know, she had it.
I hope so.
But you should add Florida to one of your next US trips. And yeah.
All right, so Moira, Daniel, Alejandro, and Fabian, please invite everyone to watch your concert.
Salama.
Yes, please invite everyone to watch your show.
Yes, so we hope you guys come out to see us perform. We can't wait to perform a song, a surprise song with Moira. It's going to be an intimate acoustic set. We're going to be playing, I believe it's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So it's Manila, then Cebu, then Davao. So bring your friends, come check out our show. I love you guys.
Yes, everyone, please come watch me and Boyce Avenue tomorrow, Saturday and Sunday, for those who are in Cebu and Davao. Tickets are still available on ticketnet.com.ph or ticket. Pick it up online from 911-555.
If you like love and you like romance, you'll enjoy the show.
Yes, and you're gonna see me fangirl while I'm on
stage. A round of sound, everyone, for Boyce Avenue and Moira. One of the biggest independent events in the world, Boyce Avenue, are coming to Manila for a concert on June 1st at the Adelaide Coliseum, together with the most streamed Filipino artist on Spotify today, Moira. The show is happening on June 1 in Manila at the Adelaide Coliseum, on June 2 in Cebu at Waterfront Hotel. We ain't ever getting